when I joined the organisation 6 or 7 years ago, there was some attention paid to energy management and carbon reduction, but I think we've raised the profile of that. We've certainly got great support from our leadership team. Well, I think we're entering an exciting phase. I think we are going to become more reliant on renewable energy. We're going to become more reliant on producing our own energy. Rolls-Royce have got interest in fuel cells. We've got interest in engines and generating equipment. So there's a lot of potential for us to utilise some of our own products, which is quite interesting. The organisation needs to drive out costs, become more efficient. So I think we need to continue to do what we've been doing on the demand side management, so keep reducing consumption, but at the same time, try and increase the proportion of energy that comes from green sources. So I'm trying to widen that responsibility of the central corporate programme. So that's the journey that we're on. And the biggest challenge is to achieve more control over our global procurement. And then the final aspect is around the impact we have on our local environment. So that's our local neighbours. We want to try and minimise the impact on them. We've enhanced the decision making to ensure that energy and carbon is part of that decision making. It will never be the deciding factor, because obviously we're looking for to build capability, to build new manufacturing facilities so that we can supply our products to our customers. But energy and carbon costs are now part of that investment decision.